Hi guys, and welcome to another episode of Themeisle WordPress tutorials and reviews. My name is Robert, and in this video I will do my best to put together the ultimate WordPress menu tutorial. You will see in and out menu creation and customization tips, how to create a vertical menu like this one, and how to add a menu to your sidebar as well. Also, I will show you how to add submenu items as drop-down, and how to add custom elements like icons, buttons, search, and so on. As you can see here, this is the so-called primary menu, which should contain elements like Home, About Us, Blog, Contact, etc. These menu elements can be linked to standalone pages, or you can just simply use them to navigate through sections, like so. At the bottom of the website, we'll find the footer menu, which contains links to privacy policy, terms of service, or other useful information like copyright, for example. The theme I use in this video is Neve, a super fast WordPress theme, which gives you unique ways to build up menus by simply dragging over the elements for up to 3 lines in the header area and 2 for the footer area. Cool, right? I will show you more about this immediately, so let's dive right in. Under Appearance on your dashboard, you can see Menus over here. Just click on it and you will be redirected to the place where you can create, edit, or delete your WordPress menu. You can access your menu settings also under Appearance, Customize, and then go to Menus. Although you can see live what's happening with your menu here, we have limited possibilities, so you will be unable to add icons and change some display options. I will use the options in the customizer for the header menu and footer menu. More about that later, so let's go back to the menus in the dashboard for now. You can access the screen options over here, and you also see 2 tabs below for editing your menus and manage locations. The menu selector drop-down, and the menu structure area where you can add menu items from pages, posts, custom links, or you can use categories and tags as well. For an e-commerce site, you will see products and product categories as well as options to add them to your menus. In the menu structure area, you are able to change the menu name, drag each item to the order you prefer, and click the arrow on the right side of the item to reveal its settings. The menu settings below are for checking whether you want to automatically add new top-level pages and to display the menu location as well. If you check this box, each new top-level page you create will be added automatically to the menu, like so. Depending on your theme, right here, you can see primary menu, footer menu, secondary menu, and other options as well. I will check the primary menu for this one. Now that we know how to access and use our menu settings, let's see how to create a menu from scratch, step by step. You can use this for any WordPress theme, but if you want more control over your header menu, install Neve and build up your menu with up to 3 lines and a bunch of useful elements like search form, button, HTML, logo, menu icon, secondary menu, and so on. What's really cool on Neve is that you can create completely different menus for mobile and desktop view. And you can change the style and layout on each line separately, and then you can adapt the style of each element to the selected skin mode. See how everything works in the recommended video above or later in the description box. You can find links to videos and useful resources as well. Moving forward, I will delete what I already have here, so you can see exactly what you need to do if you have no menu created yet. Start by entering a menu name over here. Main menu, primary menu, header menu, or whatever you have in mind. And then click Save Menu. This name will help you quickly find which menu you want to use in the drop-down. If you have different menus created for the footer area, header, secondary, and so on. Now, in the header menu, I will use home, about us, blog, and contact from pages on the left. If you have no pages created yet, just click on new page over here and create them fast. Don't worry about adding content right now. You can do it later. For some themes, the home and blog page will be created automatically when installing it, as you can see for Hestia. This theme looks really nice out of the box, with these customizable sections, which you can navigate through like so and keep it simple on one page. Let's go back to our menu settings. So, as I mentioned earlier, the menu elements in the header area will be home, about us, blog and contact. If you want to make your menu stand out with menu icons, check the recommended video above and see how it's done. There is another good video in the description box where you can learn how to create buttons like this one from your menu items, so make sure you check it out. To customize a menu item, click on this tiny little arrow, and then you can see this field where you can change the navigation label. In the screen options above, you can enable or disable advanced menu properties like link target, title attribute, CSS classes, link relationship, and description. Let me show you how it works. The link target option will let you check if the element you are editing will open the link in a new tab. If checked, that menu element will open in a new tab, as you can see right now on the screen. This could be helpful if you want your visitors to come back automatically to your site once they close that new page. The title attribute is what you can see to be shown when visitors hover over your menu element. As an example, for the home element, you can type in "Go home" in the attribute field. Once you save the changes, you can see the pop-up message when hovering over the element. Moving forward, CSS classes can be used to create buttons from your menu items. If you are linking to a website authored by your friend, you can represent this fact using the XFN framework by adding a rel friend attribute to the link in this field. The final property for screen options is the description box, which you can use to display more things about your product categories, for example. You can type in handmade, but remember that only sub-items in your menu will display descriptions. Main items will not. Now that we have finished adding elements to our menu, let's choose the display location. Primary menu is for the header area of your site, on any page or posts you navigate. So this is what we need to check, and then click on Save Menu to keep those changes. Non-clickable menu items can be used in mega menus as a category in columns, as you can see here. The video recommended above will help you know exactly how to create a mega menu like this one. If you are using a hash symbol as the link in this field of a custom link menu item, that item will redirect nowhere, so it can be called non-clickable menu item. Easy, right? Next, let's see how to create a button from any menu item you want. To do that, you need to make sure CSS classes is enabled and follow the steps in the video recommended above. The link is in the description box too. After that, you can change some parameters to customize this item, or you can create more buttons as well. Feel free to play around until you get the best out of it. Sidebar menus can be used to display blog categories on the blog page or on the sidebar of each blog post, and for product categories as well. You can also put specific pages here, like the admin access, which you can see by default on any new WordPress installation. Although it can be useful for you as the administrator, if the site is not a membership site, or you don't want other people to access your login page, avoid using it on your menus. To display menus on the sidebar, you need to create that menu first, as you do with any other menu. So, create a new menu and name it Sidebar. Add the elements of your choice from the left, but leave the display location unchecked before saving the changes. As a final step, navigate to Appearance, Widgets, and drag over the navigation menu, like so. Open its settings, enter the title over here, and then select which menu you want to display in this drop-down. Click Save once you are done, and then check out how it looks on the front end. Great! How to change your menu order coming up next, so keep watching. To do that, go back to Menus, select the menu you want to modify, and simply drag items to the place of your choice, like so. Next, I will show you how to create a drop-down under the main element, the blog, for example. Do this if you wish to have your blog categories underneath, like so. You can do the same for an online shop by using product categories, and you can create multiple drop-down menus as well. Blog categories are over here, so let's add three of them to your menu. Sure, you can add as many items as you like, but I will keep it simple. If you slightly drag any item to the right, below the main menu item, the blog in our case, that item will become a so-called sub-menu, sub-item. Let's save the changes and preview the menu so you can see exactly how sub-menu items work. Pretty simple, right? Let's see how to add custom elements, like a search functionality, to your menus. If you think about adding more elements to your menu, like a search form, for example, you need to have a theme that comes with pre-built custom items in the menu area or use third-party plugins. The easy way is with themes, and the new theme comes with two elements, search icon and also search form. You can drag over the search icon, for example, which will look like this. Or you can enable the search item as your last menu item over here. If I preview the site, you can see that when you click on the search icon, a pop-up window will cover the entire screen, and you can type in your search term over here. Then you can click the search icon on the right, or reset the entire line like so. The search form works differently, and you can use this as other big companies are using it on the header of their online shop, like Amazon, for example. Cool, right? One of the most important things when creating your WordPress menu is to make sure it is mobile responsive and mobile friendly. I think more than 70% of your visitors will navigate on your site from a mobile device, which could be tablets as well as smartphones. So, this is why you should think about creating a mobile-responsive menu. Any WordPress theme is mobile-responsive nowadays. At least, it should be. But if you want more control over how easy it is to navigate on your site from a mobile device, I suggest using the Neve theme, which has a very well-optimized menu builder, with options to create a specific menu for mobile use. When accessing your menu settings on your dashboard, you see no device-based options, but if you navigate to Appearance and then click on Customize, you can see the Header menu tab over here. To build up your mobile menu, just click on the Mobile view and then drag over the elements you want, like so. If you click on the menu icon element, you will see the Show Sidebar toggle button in the General Settings tab, which you can turn on to create a vertical menu. Drag whatever you want in this sidebar, from the elements below, but remember that when somebody clicks on the menu icon, it will open that menu. To keep it simple, you can use only your primary menu, here, along with the logo of your site, over here. And that's it. But you can also put your phone number in the sidebar as clickable HTML. I can even create a smaller logo, put the phone number in the middle, and the menu icon on the right. This will make it easier for your visitors to contact you if you want that. I think it's enough for today. If you have questions, please leave a comment below and I will do my best to answer it. If you are new here, please hit the subscribe button so you can get notified when we upload future videos about WordPress. See you in the next one.